Hi students, and welcome to today's live IELTS class. My name is Adrian, and I'm streaming to you from beautiful Budapest in the heart of Europe. I hope everybody has had a good start to their week. You're all staying healthy, strong, and optimistic about life and the world. Hi Kowal, hi Anjali, hi Gurpreet, Saswati. Nice to see many of our regular students already in the class. In this class, we are looking at the speaking section, specifically focusing on part one of the speaking section where you have to really shine and show that you are indeed a high band student, starting with a band 9. Of course, this lesson is presented to you by aehelp.com for academic IELTS success. Please visit and join us there. And for the general IELTS, check us out at gieltshelp.com. On both of our websites, we have lots and lots of materials to help you prepare for the exam. You can even find other IELTS students to practice your speaking with. I'll show you that in just a moment here. So this is our academic website here at aehelp.com. You can click that big red button to join. When you do, you get a My Student account. Of course, you get an app as well, so you can use it on your mobile. And then you will see this student partner speaking option in your My Student account. And there you can always check to see if there are other students waiting to practice their IELTS speaking with video and audio chat. You'll go to a new page, and almost always you'll find somebody in there. Right now we have Usman here waiting for someone to video or audio chat. So there's basically always somebody in the portal, oftentimes 4 or 5 people. And of course there are speaking questions as well for objects, people, places, events, ideas. So you just click on one of those. And that's absolutely free. You can access that from your general IELTS website for students studying general IELTS. You can get the ultimate package by clicking the red button, or you can join for free and try it out by clicking the green button. So do that for sure. Sammy, Abhishek, Rashika, Jainil, nice to see many of our members. I caught you out of the corner of my eye in the chat there. Welcome to another fresh week of IELTS classes. And of course, we will have IELTS classes tomorrow, Friday, and Saturday. And we will be looking at writing, task 1, task 2, as well as some reading. Semil, nice to see you in the class as well, Semil. Make sure, Semil, to join the members chat classes this week as well. Okay, hello, Purple Hearts back at you, Shaima. Students, of course, we have apps. Our apps are Academic IELTS Help, joins or links with aehelp.com, General IELTS Help app, links with gieltshelp.com. Okay. If anybody has questions about our products, about the IELTS exam, we are experts. We're in contact with British Council as well. You can always send us an email, adrian@aehelp.com, and I will definitely get back to you in due time. Good luck, Jainil. I know you got something coming up. I can see everybody wishing you good luck, so good luck on your exam. If you have questions, let me know. Yeah, I remember you sent me an email as well. Okay, so let's get into today's speaking. It's important to know that the speaking interview is about 12 minutes, sometimes a little bit more. It's a face-to-face interview with an examiner, and these days the interview is often done in a face mask, okay? So be prepared that you have to wear a face mask, and you have to wear a face mask during the interview, okay? So you have to practice. How many people are practicing their speaking wearing a face mask? Okay, yeah, Janil, I see that your exam is on the 5th of December, so you got a little bit of time still. So how many people are actually practicing with a face mask on? So Hangsi Fitness says me, yeah. Gopi says me, MacRx says not yet. Ines says I didn't try. Raisa says me. So students, if you're practicing your speaking with a face mask on, that's good. That's a really good idea. What are you discovering? What are the challenges? What's different wearing a face mask than not wearing a face mask? Okay, share it with the group. So here, just before we start our questions, I want to share a couple of really important points that could absolutely save you some marks, okay? Raisha says, we have to speak loudly. Yeah, you realize that, right, Raisha, that the mask takes down the volume. Victor says, I'm suffocating while I'm speaking. Yeah, so we have a really good video on the channel about this. You have to wear a face mask that's comfortable. And students, I highly, highly recommend not only having a breathable face mask, but let me just draw a little human here. Okay. Let's say that here you are. Okay. Now you have your wonderful ear here. Okay. Okay. Eyelashes. All right. So what I recommend, just from my experience, is that you want to have a face mask that protrudes away from your face. So have a face mask that kind of goes out in front of your face, so that there's some room between your mouth and your face mask, okay? I don't think it's a good idea to have a face mask that sits right on your face, okay? The other kind of face mask is the one that sits right on your face, like that, okay? Usually those medical masks, okay? If you have an option to bring your own, definitely bring a face mask that goes kind of out in front of your face. Number one, it's not gonna move up and down your face, okay? And number two, you have more breathing room as well, okay? Trying to speak continuously in a mask that sits right on your face is really awkward, okay? So definitely, try to get one that kind of sits out in front of your face. Okay. All right. Everybody clear on that? So, and practice with it. Practice with the face mask that you're going to use in the exam. Okay. It's really, really important. So that can make a big, big difference. Okay. All right. Okay. So, again, just to summarize that up. So, buy a quality face mask before you're speaking that does not sit directly on your mouth, but protrudes a couple of centimeters away. So that you have room to breathe and talk, and it does not ride up and down your face, okay? All right, so highly recommend it. Protrudes, okay? All right, okay. So that's number one. What I actually recommend, and this is, I think, very, very useful, okay? Hardik's asking, should I wear a medical 3 mask or an N95 mask? Hardik, I would recommend the N95 mask because the N95 masks usually are the ones that kind of go away from your face. The medical masks tend to sit right on your face, okay? All right, so the other recommendation that I have, it's a kind of a combination. So many of you heard me say this before, is go to your speaking exam about 1 hour before so that you can get comfortable with the situation. Go to the washroom if needed. And
exclamation mark, exclamation mark. Find a person or another candidate to practice your speaking wearing the mask, okay? So a lot of candidates get a little bit nervous or very nervous when they're at their in their speaking interview at the exam center, and with a face mask that becomes an extra difficult situation, just because wearing a mask increases anxiety. So it's a really good idea to not just practice before your exam wearing a face mask, but on that day, go to the exam center early, put on your mask, talk to someone, say, excuse me, would you mind practicing some speaking with me? I have a question sheet, just so we can feel more comfortable and get used to just using our mask in this exam center. Okay, all right, that can make a big difference in your performance, even a one band score difference, okay? So I always said to students to go early and practice others, but now with the face mask, it's even more important, okay? So make sure to do that. Also, before your speaking exam, you should have kind of a reminder sheet, or what I call a mental checklist, note paper with you on the exam day that reminds you of key strategies and points to pay attention to in your speaking interview. Okay, you should create this sheet with 5 to 6 points in your practice sessions leading up to the exam, okay? So for example, okay, mental checklist. Okay, and this is going to be different for different people. And Gopi Singh, okay, mental checklist, yeah. So, yeah, absolutely. So this is going to be different for different people. So remember to use quantitative information, numbers, to give good explanations. Okay, that's one very common one that people forget, or even when they remember, they don't use them often enough. Okay, Bular, great job on that band 7. Thanks for sharing that. Okay. All right, Faisal, Kareem, there's a true false not given video, HD video on the channel. Check it out, okay? All right, so mental checklist. Another common one for the mental checklist is use the question grammar and vocabulary in the answers. Okay, another really common one, so I'm giving you the ones that many, many, many students miss, okay? Another common one is look at the questions on the cue card during the 2 minutes in part two and answer all of them in the first 90 seconds. Okay, so these are some of the big ones that students tend to forget, okay? Dhruv says, buy time if needed, or ask for a repeat if needed. Yeah, okay. Diaz, yeah, Scottish accent is acceptable, okay, on the test if you're speaking English with a Scottish accent. Absolutely, okay, all right. Gopi, you should not use a template for your answers. If it seems that you're using a template to give answers, your score will go down. Chahal, I am from West Coast Canada, Victoria. Okay, so remember the mental checklist, go to the exam early, practice with a face mask. Those are the three big strategies that I'm emphasizing for you right now before we get going. And so I'm just reiterating that. And now we will start the interview as well, okay? So here we go. You go to your exam center, you have your mask on, you practice with another candidate, you looked at your mental checklist 4 or 5 minutes before you went into the exam, you had a nice big gulp of water course, okay, because your mouth can get dry, especially in a face mask, okay? It can get quite warm and hot, all right? And then you go in, and there is your examiner, a guy like me, or maybe a woman, and they will greet you and say, welcome to the speaking portion of the IELTS exam. My name is Adrian. I will be your examiner for this part of the test, and I will give you instructions for each part. First of all, may I see your identification? They will always ask you for that, for both the speaking part and the sit-down part. You will be asked to show your identification before you can begin. Okay. Janiel says, yes, of course, here it is. Please have a look. Nice, Janiel. Just keep practicing saying that smoother with a more accurate accent. Sammy says, yes, certainly. Here's my passport, which I used to register for this exam. Please have a look. Good. Okay. Let's see. Dhruv says, yes, here's my passport that I used to register for the exam. Please take a look. Nice. Show fluency right away. So don't just go yes here. Okay. You're not there to have a chit chat. You're there to show your best English. Okay. It's kind of like, think about the exam interview. I've never said it like this, but think about it like your first date. Okay. You put your best foot forward. All right. That's kind of a good way to think about it. So think of the IELTS speaking exam as your first date, okay? You put, this is an expression or an idiom in English, you put your best foot forward, but you do not want to seem fake, all right? And I'm sure all of you know what I'm talking about, girls and guys. So when you're on that first date, you want to seem like you're the greatest person in the world, but you don't want to seem fake because that's not good either. All right. That's kind of what you want to do. Good news, you only need to do it with your language, with the English language. Okay. All right. So may I see your identification? You're giving a full sentence answer without going over the top, right? That's the idea. Abhishek says, yes, of course, here you are. This is my passport, which I used to register for the exam. Please have a look. Abhishek, there's a couple things in that response that are a little bit awkward. A couple of the word order is a little bit off. Okay. Gopi, you don't need to be too quick in your speaking. You just have to be clear. Okay. Clarity and coherence are much more important than trying to speak really quickly. Okay. Akshay says, yes, of course, here's my passport that I used to register for today's exam. Please have a look. So yes, of course, here is my passport that I used to register for this exam. Please take a look. Very good. Okay, and they will take a look. They have to check off a couple of boxes on a sheet that confirms that they checked your identification and matched you with what they see. So, of course, before they give back your ID, they're going to say, what is your full name? Now, this is speaking, students, so make sure that you're also speaking. Speak and repeat in this session. Don't just write in the chat. So speak and repeat. Okay. So Sammy says, my full name is Siva Sankara. My surname is Pulivarthi. Please call me by my name, Sammy. Okay. Dipti says, my name is Dipti Oberoi. You can just address me as Dipti. You can address me as is usually if when we're, not always, but in many cases when we're equal or higher positioned than the person that we're speaking to. So usually Dipti, we will say something like, please address me as Dipti instead of you can. Okay. You can is kind of instructional. Like you can do this, you can't do that. Okay. So please address me as, or please call me. It's a little bit more polite, especially with an examiner. Okay. All right. Keep that in mind.
Victor says, my name is Victor. My given name is Victor, and my surname is Korolenko. When you say what your surname is or your family name is, always say that my first name or my given name is. Okay, Victor? So my given name is Victor, and my surname is Korolenko. Please just call me Victor, okay? Or Vic for short. Vic is common for Victor, okay? I'm not sure if you like that, Victor, that shortening. It's just a suggestion, okay? Lola Raksimova says, my full name is Rakimova Lilo. Please call me Layla, okay? So that would be your nickname, Lola, Layla. So my full name is Rakimova Lilo. Please call me by my nickname, Layla, okay? It's like in Star Wars, right? The princess, Princess Layla. All right, good. So yeah, give your full name. And let the examiner know what you want them to call you, okay? So, my full name is Alexander Droz. Please just call me Alex for short. Okay, if you have a short version of your name. So what is your full name? My full name is Alexander Droz. Please just call me Alex for short. Went with a Polish name today. All right. So here we go. Then the examiner will say, okay, Alex, here's your identification back. Now I will ask you a couple questions to get to know you better, some questions on a general topic for part one. Do you work or study? It's a very common question. Really be prepared for this one. Make sure you don't make any mistakes answering this question, okay? All right. So, let's see. Amrit says, I both work and study. I've been working as a managing director at a local theater here in the city and taking English classes, especially for this exam. Amrit, very nice answer. Okay, I like it. It's great. Nice use of present perfect, continuous. Well done. Okay, it's well done. Janiel says, well, I've both been working as a technical illustrator at Expert Global for the past 2 years and studying English for the IELTS exam so I can continue my further education in PSL in France. Okay, very nice, Janiel. That's a good answer. Again, practice smooth, quick expression, good intonation. Okay. All right. David says, not only do I work, but I also study. I work as a manager for the largest carrier in Colombia called Deliveries. I've also been studying for the IELTS exam recently because, okay, so why, David? You'd probably want to add that in there because I'm hoping to get a higher level position once I prove my English proficiency. Okay, something like that. Abhishek says, currently I'm both working as a senior technical consultant at an IT company in Ahmedabad. And from last year, I'm also pursuing an MBA in IT from Delhi University. Very nice, Abhishek. Okay, go back, practice with the fluency and intonation that I'm using. Okay. All right. Hardik Sutaria, I'm a student and graduating with a bachelor degree in the field of physiotherapy. Also, I've been studying for the IELTS exam for the last 4 months. Hardik, physical therapy, I believe is what you're trying to say there. It's physiotherapy. Physiotherapy is the correct word in English for that. Make sure you know that. That's your major. Okay, you don't want to make a mistake with that. Physiotherapy. Okay. All right. Gopi, please don't spam with the hearts. Okay. All right. Diaz Stroke says, I'm currently studying at university called Higher School of Economics, but actually there are other faculties, not just economics. As for me, I'm going to work as a barista
or a barrister. Oh, sorry, not barista. You're not making coffee. A barrister, okay? Lawyer, yeah, barrister. Barista, barrister, don't confuse those. Barista makes coffee. Barrister is a lawyer. That's right. Okay, Diaz, that's good. Diaz, don't go off topic. So be a little bit more direct. So currently I'm studying at a university called Higher School of Economics. In fact, I'm studying law there as well. I'm hoping to be a lawyer in the future. Okay. All right. Good job. Yeah, so this is where you can use a correlative conjunction like both and, not only, but also. Lepe Yun says, I currently both work in an IB school as a laboratory technician during the day, and I study IELTS at night with the aim of getting a higher degree of education for my future career of teaching in university. Lepe, I'm guessing. Finish that up. Okay. So I am currently both working as an IELTS instructor and studying the British Council certified agent course so that I can help students around the world achieve their study goals. All right. So, do you work or study? I'm currently both working as an IELTS instructor and studying the British Council Certified Agent course so that I can help students around the world achieve their study goals, okay? So, here I'm using ING, using the correlative conjunction both and. That's emphasizing the two different activities that I'm doing. Okay, answering that question very, very clearly. Okay, now the next question, what do you like to do in your leisure time? Okay, so again, it's your first date. You're putting your best foot forward, all right? So you're speaking in nice, full, clear, original sentences. You want to be original, you want to be genuine, but you don't want to go over the top. Okay, so what do you like to do in your leisure time? Okay. Ferdavs, Nabiev, in my free time, I love to play football if the weather is fair. If not, I play video games online with my friends all over the world. Yesterday it was raining cats and dogs, so I was stuck inside for 2 hours playing Call of Duty. See that, Ferdavs? Throw in. So when you're referring to the weather, when you're giving a typical answer, Ferdavs, that's where you can throw in a common kind of idiom, okay? I always tell students be really, really careful with idioms, okay? If you do not use an idiom accurately, it's horrible, it sounds bad, you lose marks, you lose coherence. But for example, if you say it was raining cats and dogs, it's clear that what you're saying is that there was a lot of rain. It was really heavy rain. So you were staying inside and you played Call of Duty with your friends. You played PUBG on your phone for 3 hours. Okay, whatever it is, be original, right? Be original. Finish it off with an example, smooth flowing example, okay? Amrit says, especially in my downtime, I not only love to watch comedy series, but also I like reading novels. Just yesterday, I completed the novel Think and grew reach about an hour by Napoleon Hill. Okay, the end of that, Amrit, the example there is a little bit difficult to understand. You might want to rethink that, okay, so you can express that clearer, all right? Juan Pablo Avila, in my spare time, I usually read books or watch TV shows in English because it helps me get involved with the language. Last week, I started watching The Office, and now I'm watching an episode per day. Yeah, good for you. If I'm not mistaken, that's that comedy, Juan. It's quite funny. A little bit strange conversations in that show, but yeah, definitely will help you to keep up with pop culture and have fun doing it, right? It's a funny show. Okay. Let's see. Abdulaziz.
Panjiev says, I often create a website when I have some time for doing that. That's my hobby. And by habit, I'm going to continue on this path until it becomes a career. What kind of a website is one that you've created recently, Abdulaziz? So a little bit, I get what you're saying. Careful, students, when you're being really honest. It's good to be honest, but careful not to get yourself into a situation where your honesty becomes really difficult to explain. So Abdulaziz, if you like to create websites during your free time because you're passionate about it and it's what you want to later do as your profession as well, that's fine. Just make sure that you can clearly explain that and give an example. Otherwise, you're going to trap yourself in an awkward conversation where you're losing marks left, right, and center because you're not able to express yourself clearly. So if you get really excited to tell the truth because you've got a great idea, that's fine. Just make sure you don't trap yourself. Okay, that's a really important tip. I see that oftentimes with students where what do you like to do in your leisure time? I love reading books about quantum physics in my spare time because exploring the holonomic universe is a very interesting take on the possible nature of existence. If you start to get into this kind of an answer, fine. Just make sure that you can actually use the English to express yourself clearly. Otherwise, the examiner is going to kind of look at you and go, all right, we'll just go to the next question. Okay, so the other day, I read an interesting book on this topic titled The Dripping Faucet. Okay, all right. So, what do you like to do in your leisure time? I love reading books about quantum physics in my spare time because exploring the holonomic universe is a very interesting take on the possible nature of existence. Just the other day, I read an interesting book on this topic titled The Dripping Faucet. Okay, fine. As long as it's clear. Okay. All right. The examiner will say, okay, let's talk about television. Okay, I see a couple of people are wondering, what does holonomic mean? It's connected to the concept of a holograph. Check into it. It'll be a fun quest for you to discover the meaning of holonomic universe. Okay, the examiner at this point might say, let's talk about television. How often do you watch the TV? Okay, adverb of frequency, definitely recommended here. Always, never, sometimes, rarely. Okay, use that in your answer. All right. Pandya Viren says, oftentimes I watch TV for 1 to 2 hours a day and watch the news to update myself. About the headlines in world news, okay? Kawal Bashatia says, I do watch the TV on a daily basis, mostly during the morning and evenings as well. I start my day watching the news and then the evenings I watch some TV series. Okay, Kawal, good answer. Maruga says, to be honest, I watch TV daily. I watch the news to update myself with information around the world and also some reality TV shows that I find really interesting. Saswati says, due to my hectic work schedule, I don't get much time to watch TV during the weekdays, but on the weekend, I always watch a movie for relaxation. I would say I watch TV 3-4 times in a week for a total of maybe 8 hours. Okay. All right. So Mert Alper says, if it's a, how often can I say not at all for my answer? Yeah, you can. You can say never or not at all. So I don't watch TV at all. I believe it turns a person's mind into mashed potatoes. So I haven't had a TV in my home for the past 10 years. And instead, I'm always reading books. Okay, so you can. Just make sure that you express yourself fluently and clearly. Giving negative answers like not at all or I don't have a TV, you just have to be careful that you don't speak in a very short response, okay? If you answer no, not at all, or I don't know for every question, your exam will be over very quickly and you'll probably get like a band 3, 4, okay? Simply because the examiner can't judge your English language. It could be a 9, but if they can't judge that you're a 9, they can't give you a 9. They can only give you a 9 if you can prove that you are a 9, okay? So it's your job to prove to the examiner that you are a band 9, okay? Shangara Singh says, I watch television a lot as I use it to listen to telecast of religious hymns from the central Sikh temple in the mornings and in the evenings. Okay, Shangara, good. Make sure that you can say that clearly. Careful with awkward diction, okay? Notaraxan says, to tell you the truth, I don't have any time to watch TV, but when I'm in a bad mood, I watch comedies. Last time I remember watching TV was maybe 4 weeks ago for a couple hours. I had some problems at work, so I went home early and watched an Adam Sandler film. Okay, finish the idea, show fluency, okay? I occasionally watch television. I would say about 3 to 4 times a week for about an hour. I usually watch a documentary to learn about history or the world around me. Just the other day, I watched A Life on Planet Earth by a documentary by David Attenborough, something like that. Okay, so answer, explain, example, and that's how you get the high mark. Okay, so here we go. Qualitative, then quantitative. Occasionally, my interpretation of occasionally is 3 to 4 times a week, okay? So I occasionally watch television. I would say about 3 to 4 times a week for about an hour. I usually watch a documentary to learn about history or the world around me. Just the other day, I watched A Life on Our Planet, a documentary by David Attenborough. Okay, it's quite a popular one these days on Netflix. Sure, many of you have seen it. Okay. All right. Next question. What is your favorite TV show and why? Okay. They might ask you why, the examiner. They might just say, what is your favorite TV show? Always answer the why question. So, what is your favorite TV show? NS says, my number one choice when it comes to TV shows is Jimmy Fallon's show on NBC. He's full of energy and laughs. Not only does he play games, but also makes a great creates great conversation with his guests. Jimmy Fallon, NS. Yeah, funny guy. Absolutely. He's come into his own over the years. Good. All right. Sammy says, as I mentioned just before, I watch Superbook last night. That is my favorite program on TV. This program is telecasted 3 times a week. The last episode is Love Your Neighbor, which was just awesome. Okay, very good, Sammy. Yeah, thrice a week, it's okay. Yeah, I would say three times a week is a bit more natural in my neck of the woods, so in West Coast Canada, but thrice a week is okay too. All right. Let's see. Harry Coder says, my favorite show is The Titanic. It's amazing. Leonardo DiCaprio was taking place as Jack, the character, and Kate Winslet was Rose's character. They had a great romantic drama action show. Harry, that's a movie. It's not really a show. Okay. Careful, students. Candidates, show means a series, usually. TV show, especially. Okay. So it's not a movie. It's a TV show or a TV series. Don't confuse that. Okay. So this is something like, if you can't come up with anything, just come up with something like Friends. Okay. All right. But it's got to be a TV show. Okay. Rajveer says, my number one show on TV is Friends, which is usually aired on HBO. This is a comedy about six friends. I often feel decompressed after watching it. Okay. Very good, Rajveer. Yeah. Good explanation. Good answer. I would take out often. So I feel relaxed and happy after watching it because it's a comedy, right? Than Lee says, well, my favorite TV show is Phay Phim. It is a show in Vietnam where people talk about their reactions to films. Most of the time, they explain an interesting take on the film, and I like this kind of critique or interpretation. Okay, Than Lee, good. You're being honest. Just make sure that you're making sense. Okay? That's what I warned everyone about a few moments ago, is that it's okay to give an honest answer. Just make sure that you can explain it clearly. Okay? Manjot Kumar says, I must admit that Friends is my favorite TV show, even though it's a pretty old one. I feel it's worth watching at present as well. We can learn a lot of English and have fun at the same time. Very good, Manoj. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, so my favorite show recently has been Game of Thrones, although it is very violent and vulgar, it gives an incredibly detailed depiction of medieval times in a fantasy world, and the story is quite captivating. It airs every Monday at 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Okay, so there we go. Again, be really careful when you're giving an honest answer. Make sure that you can explain it. Here, I'm teaching you some more grammar and vocabulary as well. Notice how I'm using the present perfect. So my favorite show recently has been Game of Thrones. Although it is very violent and vulgar, it gives an incredibly detailed depiction of medieval times in a fantasy world, and the story is quite captivating. It airs every Monday at 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Doesn't really anymore, but that doesn't matter. Okay. All right. You shouldn't say, so Diaz says, I cannot think of another show right now. I apologize. Diaz, you got to come up with something, okay? Even if it's a cartoon, Spider-Man, whatever, okay? There are so many shows out there. It's very difficult to believe that a person cannot come up with the name of any show, even in their own language, in the heat of the moment, okay, under time pressure.
So you have to think, if you don't know, like let's say you're having a little bit of difficulty, then you can ask for some time. You can say, well, let me think about that because I watched quite a few different shows. The one that I'm really enjoying these days is. So buy yourself a little bit of time to come up with an idea. Okay. Lubna says, the TV show that has kept me hooked to the TV is Ellen's show. I love the way the host keeps the audience entertained till the end. Recently, this show has been taken down and I'm really upset about it. Okay, Lubna. That works. That's good. All right. I'm guessing you're talking about the Ellen DeGeneres show. Okay. All right. Let's jump a question or two. Let's go to this one. So, have TV shows changed since you were a child? Have TV shows changed since you were a child? Give me a nice full sentence answer for that one. Okay. So don't try to jump ahead, students, with the questions. I know I kind of surprised you with this one by jumping some questions. Have TV shows changed since you were a child? This is obviously present perfect. Give me an answer in present perfect. Okay. Don Lee says, there are many more shows these days in different languages, and content of these shows have also improved, offering viewers a range of choices to satisfy their viewing needs. Yeah, Don, I like how you answered very quickly. However, I do want you to use the present perfect. So yeah, TV shows have become quite different. Many more shows have been added to TV programming in recent years. As well, there has been an improvement in their overall quality, both visually and in their content. Notice, Don, how I'm using present perfect. Have improved, have added, has changed. Okay, so lots of present perfect when the question is in present perfect. Okay. Vedant Khanna says, my all-time favorite show is Tarak Mehta Kaulta Chasma. I love the way they show how to live with different people belonging to different communities. Okay, Vedant, very nice answer for the previous question. Okay, Avi Studios says, yes, TV shows are totally different now than in the past. They were black and white in the past and there was no clarity of picture, but now there are many movies that have high quality. Okay, Avi, so the overall quality of picture and sound has improved a lot for the modern shows because of the improvement in technology. Okay, also, how about the story, the content, the characters? Talk about that. David Valencia says, TV shows have suffered several modifications during the last 20 years. I remember watching funny comedies 15 years ago. However, these comedies are not around anymore, and it seems that new viewers are much more demanding. Okay, David, I get the first part of it. The last part about the demanding viewers, I'm not exactly sure what you mean by that. Okay. Mazir says, absolutely they have changed, because when I was a child, I always watched a meaningful series, but present day, it's all about love stories and meaningless plots or plot lines. Okay. All right. Abhay Nathani, yes, it has changed. It's active, not passive. Yes, it has changed over the past 10, 20 years, because when I was a child, comedies, superheroes, and fairy tale shows were mostly available, but nowadays it's horror and action TV shows and much more fashion. Okay, Abhay, I think there are a lot of superhero shows these days too, but you know what? Truth doesn't matter on the IELTS. So yes, I think the shows over the years have become very different than in the past. Of course, as technology has improved. So too has the audio and visual qualities of TV series and movies. Beyond that, the content in many cases has become worse. When I was a child, there was a lot less violence and more meaningful messages to production. Okay, all right. So here we go. Repeat after me. Have TV shows changed since you were a child? Yes, I think the shows over the years have become very different than in the past. Of course, as technology has improved, so too has the audio and visual qualities of TV series and movies. Beyond that, the content in many cases has become worse. When I was a child, there was a lot less violence and a lot more meaningful messages in the productions. Okay, so notice my use of present perfect, have become, okay, has improved, improved as well, so too has improved, okay, has become worse. So I'm using present perfect over and over again to show the examiner that I can use complex grammar, okay, that will also help your mark to go up. All right, students, I'm going to quit there for today, but you should keep going. You should keep practicing. I'm actually going to post the lessons for tomorrow on our YouTube channel here in a couple of minutes. But what you should do is you should go to our websites, aehelp.com, glshelp.com, and use that free speaking service with other students. So you can join for free, click the green try demo button, use the student partner speaking function, and continue practicing and actually speak. So instead of just chatting and repeating what I say, now's your chance to speak with other students. Of course, if you enjoy our website, I highly, highly recommend using the premium package, as many, many, many students do, and you will for sure improve your band scores, okay? So check us out, aehelp.com, glshelp.com. Really nice work, everyone, in today's class. I will be back with more IELTS tomorrow. There was a lot of really good responses in the chat today, so I'm very proud of you. Have a fantastic rest of your day. If it's late in your country, sweet dreams. Much love to all of you. I'm Adrian, signing out from Budapest. See you tomorrow. Bye.